The double X cursor is very versatile and can be used for doing lots of different types of analysis. To open up a double X cursor, hold down the control key, right click in any display, pick Add Double Cursor X. You can position the cursor over the frequency range you want to analyze. Right click on the cursor to do calculations. Here I'm going to pick Max, and now I have the maximum value and the frequency it occurs at between these two frequency lines. As I move the cursor, those values will update. If I want to copy the max to Excel, I can just right click, pick copy values, and paste it in Excel. Here I have a damped sinusoid over time, and if I was wondering what the frequency is, I can position my double X cursor between two peaks in the sinusoid, right click, pick calculations, frequency, and now I have the frequency of the sinusoid. Another type of analysis I can do is a linear regression. In this RPM time curve, I might be interested in the acceleration rate over a certain segment. If I right click on the cursor, pick calculations, linear regression, I get the acceleration slope, an offset, and an R squared factor for a line fit to the data. Here I have a spectrum, and in the spectrum, I'm interested in the RMS value over a certain frequency range. If I right click on the double X cursor, pick calculations RMS, the RMS value is put into the legend for me. I can position this cursor exactly where I want it. So if I want to go from 150 Hertz up to exactly 300 Hertz, I can just double click on the cursors, type in the number that I want. I can add another double X cursor if I want. So if I'm interested in the RMS values over a different frequency range, I can add that to the display. And to keep myself from being confused about where these cursors are, if I right-click on the cursor and pick Properties, I can assign it a fill color. And as I do that, they can have different colors. So now I know which band is which, and I can even overlap them to see how the colors mix.